we're going to a different economy, and we're going to be learning more about that as we go. But clearly, we're learning that things can be done from remote locations. We're learning that technology can replace people even more than we thought.
We're not going back to the same economy. We're recovering, but to a different economy, and it'll be one that is more leveraged to technology. And I worry that that is going to make it even more difficult than it was for many workers.
In Silicon Valley, and my friends who work in technology know that what we did to the manufacturing workers, we are now going to do to the retail workers, the call center workers, the fast food workers, the truck drivers, and then even bookkeepers, accountants, insurance agents, lawyers, and on through the economy. So what happened to the manufacturing workers is a very clear sign.
This effort, and China has big plans for this. They intend to seed their digital yuan into the global environment by giving it away to visitors at next winter's Olympics. When they arrive at the airport, they're going to get yuan digital wallets. They're going to receive digital yuan. They're going to use it throughout their visits to Beijing, and then they're going to take it back to their home countries. They see this as a huge advantage. Why? Because who controls the underlying protocols, who controls the underlying standards of the future of money will control the future of money.
Welcome to the Crypto Teacher Stock Channel. And guys, please like and subscribe if you do like what you're listening to. Please inform your friends and family and spread all over social media. It is imperative that we get back to learning finances and understand how the world really works. Because once we understand how the world really works, we understand that everything is planned out. And we get into the funny articles first. We have from MIT, universal basic income is here. And guys, we know MIT is a new world order school, the best and greatest minds. Also, we have the Colonial Pipeline restarts after hacking. And remember, guys, if you checked out my video on the main channel, Crypto Teacher, they shut it off. It wasn't the hack, guys. And also, Biden signs an executive order right behind it on what? Cybersecurity. And what do they want? They want that data. And we know how this starts. It starts with government sharing data, and then the corporations are going to start sharing it. Of course, they're going to make it seem like they're forced to, but companies like Apple that don't share data, they're going to have to. This is all part of the plan, guys. No privacy whatsoever. They won't want you to have anything. Do not fall for these narratives, I'm letting you know. But let's get over into stocks, guys. As we see, the Asian stock market was down also. Remember, we are in a global economy now. And Jim Cramer goes over Cathie Wood's top tech stocks are heading lower. And guys, we already know with higher yields, we know inflation, we know that the stock market is out 6 months, a year out. We know there's going to be a pullback because we know what's designed, that fourth industrial revolution. They have to build it. They printed all this money, not for any reason, had nothing to do with the C word. It was to build the fourth industrial revolution. And we see stocks having this pullback. But believe me, guys, they're going to move up this month. Now, starting June, July, we know those last 3 months are going to roll off inflation. So the fact is that, yes, in May, we still will move up. But starting June, July, we will start heading lower. The reason why we know, because there is a lot of narratives going on, guys. Cyber attacks. We have the issue over in Israel. We have the rising power of China. So there's a lot of moving pieces. We just have to keep an eye on it because, remember, they want us to follow the narrative so nobody's looking at the money. Nobody's looking at the stock market. They're going to be worried about what's over here. Climate change, it's another thing, another agenda. So we just have to make sure we pay attention to the narrative, but that's never our focus. Always keep your eyes on your money. And I forgot this funny article, guys. We have Ohio ends mask mandate June 2nd. And sets up $1 million weekly lottery for vaccine incentive. So, guys, anytime you have to incentivize someone to do something, something's not right, and we know why. Now, basically, we have Palantir accepts Bitcoin. And, guys, like I said on my Crypto Teacher channel, Palantir is a government-contracted company. Majority of contracts come from the government. So you're telling me the government is paying in Bitcoin? Now we have Elon Musk with big news today. says that Tesla will stop accepting Bitcoin for car purchases, stating what? Climate change. Guys, we see the agendas. Pay attention to the narratives. They're all over the place. But do not put your focus on it. It is always a distraction. I've been over it several times. Elon Musk is nothing but a puppet. If you don't know, now you know. Now, we know cloud and cybersecurity stocks have taken a beating. But believe me, they're going to come roaring back. And looking over a few cybersecurity stocks, we have Norton LifeLock. We have Zscaler Inc. We have CACI International. And then, of course, again, Palantir. And I'm not your financial advisor, not financial advice. Please do your own research. A lot of stocks are taking a beating right now that are going to come roaring back. We look at cannabis. It's going to come roaring back because we know what's needed in the fourth industrial revolution. And the same thing goes for Palantir, these electric cars. And we see how important these electric cars are if you look at the East Coast. Electric cars are going to be very important because they can shut off gas at any time. Same way they can do electricity. But at the same time, we know what their agenda is. Renewables is the future. So remember, guys, we invest. We're not betting. We're not gambling. Investing means you're going to hold 3, 5, 10 years and just reap the benefits. Those who've been with me since the beginning of 2020 understand, because I preach it. There's a difference between investing and betting. And remember, greed kills. You're not going to always find the perfect bottom. You're not going to always find the perfect top. But I definitely, guys, when you know the plan, stick to the plan. And believe me, follow the money. It will take care of you. Especially if you're Generation Z, a millennial, you're going to be fine. Now, guys, we also have Hertz does a reorganization. 6 billion shares went up 50%. So please do your research. And, guys, going over the actual indicators, we had the dollar up. We had the VIX up. And then also, guys, we had yields slightly down. And the VIX has moved up fast. And, guys, we know, like I stated, June and July yields are going to start moving up. And then also inflation is going to run wild. The only thing the Fed can do is raise interest rates. And we know they're not going to do that on a $7 trillion balance sheet. They have to start tapering. And we know once they start tapering, we know what's going to happen with the stock market. We know what's going to happen with cryptos. But we know that cryptos are the future. So you sit back, strategize, make sure your portfolio is built correctly. But guys, that's all I have for you. Please make sure you go to my main channel, Crypto Teacher. Like, subscribe, learn the new economy. It's so important for you to get educated and your friends to get educated. And spread the channel. Learn cryptos, blockchain, also this channel. Like, subscribe, spread everywhere, and y'all have a wonderful day.